Looking to improve your game? You can now sign up for CFB Pro using the promo code LVD. Get access to articles and deck guides by the world's best. Hello and welcome to another Magic Arena gameplay video. Today we're taking a look at my very first Zendikar Rising draft that I was able to play in the early access event courtesy of Wizards of the Coast. So this video is also considered sponsored by Wizards. So let's dive right into it here with our pack one, pick one. Our rare is a Pathway. Uncommons include Fledgling, which is definitely a nice one. 2 mana 1-1 that can get a plus 1 counter with Landfall. Cleric for kind of the multicolor green decks. Relic Golem for the blue-black mill archetype. Then what are some of the best commons? Bubble Snare, nice removal. Vanquish the Weak, a nice one too. And Visionary draws a card. Constrictor for the black-green plus one counter deck. There's some decent commons in the pack. I think it's probably still going to be the Fledgling for me. Just as a very solid 2-drop that will grow over time. Bubble Snare, decent removal. Vanquish the Weak, decent removal. Those are probably pretty close behind the Fledgling in power level. But yeah, let's go for the 2-drop here. So, second pack. If we had taken the Relic Golem, then Thief would be definitely the pick here. Had we taken one of the blue or black removal spells, Thief would have also been a nice second pick. We did take Fledgling, so what are we looking at? There's still another Vanquish the Weak as good removal, Rabbit Bite in green, if we want to move away from black. Since we're then also passing a Thief. Not the biggest fan of Unity, Disenchant's kind of a sideboard card, Stampede is nice, but I don't think I'm second picking it. So I think it's between Vanquish and Rabbit Bite. And maybe I should move out of black and just take the Rabbit Bite instead here and see if we can maybe draft a green-white deck instead. Third pack. We are seeing a decent amount of black between Thwart the Grave. Mind Drain is not anything special, but Blood Beckoning is a nice 2-for-1. In green, there's only Nissa's Zendikon, which is playable but not amazing. And in white, there's only the Outrider, really, so it's no amazing green or white cards. Probably just take Thwart the Grave. It's a party card, but it can get potentially two creatures back from the graveyard. So it's a nice 2-for-1. So now I'm kind of regretting taking Rabbit Bite over Vanquish the Weak, but we're just taking good cards in each color, kind of seeing what color ends up being open. And alright, probably not going to pass up on another Vanquish. Veteran Adventure is also quite good, especially if we're going to focus on the party mechanic a little bit. But Vanquish is still quite good here. Ascetic, playable but not exciting. Same with a Gloom Hunter. Subtle Strike's also a nice trick. And it's also pretty late Royal Eruption. Probably the best card in the pack overall. Chronicler can be nice for the kicker deck, but we're pretty far from any kicker synergies. So I'll just take Vanquish, and then who knows, we might be black-white or green-black. Seeing a decent amount of white cards here. Tazim Raptor, a nice way to re-enable Landfall later in the game. I also like Fortification quite a bit. Plus one counter at instant speed for just one mana, or it can be a land. I think I'm gonna lean towards the Raptor. Makindi Ox can also be a decent curve topper. But I do actively want to play this Fledgling, so maybe we can end up black-white. Typically has some life gain synergies with the Clerics, but maybe we'll just end up with kind of a black-white mid-range deck with a reasonable curve without too much Cleric synergy. Best cards here include Living Tempest, 5 mana, 3-3, Flyer with Flash. Blood Price is playable, but you don't want too many of them. But maybe as a one-off, we could still take it. The green card skill, the heights, is also decent. Broken Wings is more of a sideboard card. So it's between Blood Price or maybe kind of speculate on blue with a Living Tempest. But I'll stick to black. And another Tazim Raptor seems fine. Not the biggest fan of Mesa Lynx. 2-1 on offense, 2-3 on defense. Sneak is for the blue-black archetype. Silencer, good in the party mechanic deck, but it's pretty expensive. Just take another 3-mana 2-2 flyer. Eighth pick, pressure points is random filler, smite the monsters. Typically don't mind having one of these in the main deck. So I'll just keep taking the white cards here. Scythe Cat can also be nice in green. And a Sorcerer, that's also pretty late actually. Great in the Wizard archetype. But we're pretty far from being blue-red. Diviner also nice in blue. We did wield the other Smite the Monstrous, as well as the Cleric, Visionary, and Constrictor. Black-white is not going to be the best deck for Constrictor. Don't really want a second Smite. Maybe I just speculate on green and take a Visionary here. In case black doesn't pan out. Take a Unity. Maybe Outrider. Don't have a ton of creatures that go with the party mechanic. I've got a bunch of birds and griffins. I don't know, maybe I'll take a Zendikar instead. And maybe an Ascetic. Don't have anything at 5 yet. So after the first pack, definitely not an amazing pack, but we're setting ourselves up to either be green-white, black-green, or black-white, some sort of combination of those. Alright, we opened an on-color rare with Soul Shatter, fine removal spell. What else do we have? Healer could be nice if we ended up with more clerics and cleric synergies. There's a Sky Dancer for the rogue deck. Vanquish the Weak would be nice, and then Gnarled Colony is also quite solid, especially in the black-green plus one counter deck. But I'm just going to take Soul Shatter here and then hope to wheel, I don't know, one of the green cards if we end up green. I don't think we're going to wheel Vanquish the Weak. We don't even necessarily know what our primary color is at this point. Black-white probably has the highest card quality overall. We did pass some pretty good black-blue rogue cards, so we don't necessarily expect to get a ton of black cards in pack 2, but we did cut off whites reasonably well, so we should be getting most of the good white cards passed to us. There's another Thwart the Grave, although it is going to be pricey without many creatures to fill our party. Some okay black cards, Feed the Swarm, Dreadworm. I think I'm just going to take the Takedown, solid removal spell. That can also be played as a land. Second Thwart seems a bit much. Feed the Swarm is definitely solid. But I'll take a Takedown. And then I'm probably looking to be black-white. Alright. Captain. Definitely a strong card, but maybe not at its best in this deck. Yeah, we don't have a single creature with the party creature types. But Shadow's Verdict can be a nice sweeper. So, I think that's going to be my pick, and then try and kind of draft a more mid-rangey deck that can play a good late game, and then we can maybe wipe the board with Shadow's Verdict. It does kill all our creatures so far, but of course, if we draw it, we can kind of play around it a little bit. No black cards here. Farsight Adept is fine. 3-3 that draws a card for each player, but it counts as a wizard, and we're not going to have many wizards in black-white, so it's a good way to fill out a party. Cinderclasm, definitely a good red card here. Another Living Tempest. Not super interested in the relic, but Shepherd of Heroes is fine. 3-4 flyer, gains a bit of life. We're not really the sneak deck. Another pretty late Royal Eruption as well, so we're definitely passing some good red cards. Alright, Felidar's great. Especially with double Tazim Raptor to keep enabling landfall. Beckoning would also be nice to get some creatures back from the graveyard. So, could use some 2-drops maybe, although they are not necessarily the best combo with Shadow's Verdict. But we've got a bit of removal, some decent flyers, a bit of card draw. Probably just take another Adept over Sentinel, although I could see Sentinel being a nice finisher in a slower deck like this. No black or whites. Bunch of red and green landfall cards here. Any chance I like splash of Vastwood Surge just for the kicker ability? It's unlikely. Just take a cat. Although at this point I don't see myself switching into green. Supplies is nice because we don't have many 2-drops, so it's a way to kind of spend our mana and eventually draw an extra card. And maybe we'll play a Silencer. Another Scythe Cat. Surprised to see Cinderclasm this late. So yeah, as expected, we didn't see a ton of black in Pack 2. But we should see some in Pack 3. We opened Archpriests. Another Emiria Captain. Yeah, nothing amazing for us. I'll probably still take the Priest just as kind of a curve filler to enable some of the party shenanigans. But it's not at its best in our deck. And then maybe hope to wheel Emiria Captain. Yeah, Baloth is a nice finisher. Don't really need another disenchant, already have blood price. Don't have many rogues to go with a skulker. And we don't have much life gain to go with the priest, so not really an ideal pack for us. Maybe I should just take the rogue to fill out the party since we don't have any rogues yet. Or I can just take Baloth and maybe pivot into green. I mean, we do have double Scythe Cats as well, so we do have a decent chunk of green cards. Maybe they're just better than black at this point. And Stomper's a nice curve topper. So I can maybe splash black for a bit of removal. It's definitely an option. So we're going to be a little light on playables here, but yeah, Stomper's a nice curve topper for kind of the landfall aggro archetype. So I didn't mind taking it here. Another Felidar seems great. Pretty happy with that. Blightblade, cheap one drop that is also a rogue for party. Shadowcat is kind of for the plus one counter archetype. Could take another Raptor, although we already have two. I like a Blightblade here. Big fan of the recovery. Regrowth would also be fine, because we have multiple landfall creatures and ramping is also useful. So both of these are close. It might actually be regrowth with double Scythecat and double Felidar to enable landfall, and it can maybe let me splash black more easily if that's something I need to do. Ooh, wow. That's a late 7th pick Fledgling, another Felidar would be great, Raptor, Scythecat. Pretty late Royal Eruption, we've seen three of these pretty late, but very happy with another Fledgling. Probably don't need a second Stomper when we have Baloth and Stomper. Survivor's decent. Ox is okay if we need a 5-drop. Surge could help ramp and fix our mana. Also decent follow-up to one of our landfall creatures. This one's close between Survivor and Surge. I think I'll go with the Surge, as it's a bit more high impact. Reclaim the Waste could also let me splash. I don't think I need Pickaxe. Most of my landfall creatures are pretty good by themselves. So yeah, I guess now that we take Reclaim, it's going to be pretty easy to splash a few black removal spells like Vanquish the Weak and Soul Shatter. Alright, so wasn't the easiest draft to navigate, but I think we ended up with a reasonable deck. So let's see. These are kind of our non-creature spells. So how good is Archpriest? We've got Rogue, Cleric, Wizard, Wizard, Cleric. It's not amazing. Yeah, I don't think Archpriest is where I want to be in this deck. But the Fledgling seem great. Blightblade is just a good defensive creature early on. Spare Supplies is fine since we don't have many 2-drops. The Adepts seem okay, just because we have a powerful late game, so drawing cards is nice. And if we draw lands, it can still enable landfall, so drawing cards is especially nice in a deck that has expensive spells, and also doesn't mind drawing lands in a late game. Scythecat and Raptor look good, Felidar, Visionary, Shepherds, just a fine curve filler. Could maybe play a Ascetic as well, just to give us another big creature. Could main deck a Broken Wings. Don't know if that's necessary. And then don't want any of these other black cards. This is 41. Could be a 16 lander since I have a few ways of searching up lands between Regrowth, Surge, and Reclaim the Wastes. Reclaim the Wastes typically kind of counts as a land. So I think that's reasonable. Do I even need two black sources? Or do I get away with a single one? I think I can get away with one swamp. I don't really need double black. And I've got three ways of searching up my swamp. Pretty evenly split between green and white. My 2-drops are mostly white, and my 3-drops are mostly white, so I think I'm going with 8 planes on this one. There's always a chance we play against a blue-black mill deck and they end up milling my swamp, but that's a risk I'm willing to take. And then one Smite the Monstrous, Vanquish, Soul Shatter, take down Rabbit Bite. So we've got a decent chunk of removal. So we've got 16 lands, And a couple ways to find more lands. I mean, we do want enough land still to enable landfall. Takedown can also be played as a land, but that's a good thing when we have this many landfall creatures. So, yeah, seems okay. It is true that there are a few land destruction effects that people might main deck, so if they know we have a single swamp, they could potentially mana screw us. But it is best of one, so hopefully they don't figure that out. No white mana, but we've got a spare supplies. I'll keep. Plenty of lands in hand for landfall, and eventually to cast our Baloth. Opponent on Naya Colors. I guess I could consider attacking, because this is going to grow up to a 3-4, so I'm not going to be able to block it profitably. Don't want to trade it for my Felidar, I don't think. Yeah. That's probably fine. Opponent's got a Relic Golem, so they're going to try mill us. That's okay, we weren't gonna spend mana on spare supplies for quite a while. And we'll just pass. So this requires 8 or more cards in our graveyard. They do get to double landfall here, so that's pretty good. A 6-7 Felidar. No attacks. Alright, I can get my swamp before it's too late. Don't necessarily need to kick it since we've got plenty of lands in hand. I should probably keep the swamp in hand actually in case they have the red land destruction card. No good attacks. Well, we've got a flying creature now. Next turn I could play Baloth. 6-6, not incredibly large. I might have to wait to kick it instead. Prowling Felidar is definitely a house. 7-8 already. What's going to be faster, us killing them with our flyer or the opponent milling me? It's going to be close. Thanks with all. Interesting. They could have a pump spell, of course. Maybe the Inspire Charge with Kicker. So +2/+1 to the entire team. So in that case, I just want to block like this. Yeah, that's probably fine. This would go up to 9/9 if they have +2/+1. So I could try and double block it with my two Felidars, but if it's just like an instant speed bounce spell or removal spell instead, double blocking's pretty bad. It's just a Might of Murasa, so double blocking or triple blocking Felidar would not have worked out. Blightblade is a pretty nice draw though. So I need three more mana before I can kick this. Five cards in graveyard, so this can't attack or block yet. Ooh, Stomper. Huh, that's interesting. Normally picking up lands in this spot could be good because of the Felidar. But maybe we wanna try and kick the Baloth. I would still need to draw an extra land before I can kick it, but it's pretty likely to happen in two draw steps. And then this would be a 10-10. It's definitely a big deal. I think we hold. We have one black spell left in the deck. Relic Golem can now officially attack and block. And they did mill a decent chunk of our removal spells. Scythecat. So 15 cards remaining. Can now kick the Baloth. Don't think an attack with everyone is beneficial, but the Baloth can attack. I'm fine if it trades for the Felidar. And the flyer can attack. Alright, hopefully they don't have instant speed landfall here. Alright, got rid of their big Felidar. Ten cards remain. Surprised they activated this during their own turn instead of trying to block with it. I'm just gonna attack with all and see what happens. Or I could Rabbit Bite first, but yeah, maybe I can Rabbit Bite with a Blight Blade actually, in case they have a way of untapping it maybe. Hopefully no sweepers. They could have that 8 mana sweeper here. It would only be mislethal if they were empty-handed. Alright, GG's. play this on turn one. Not sure which 3-drop to play here, I've got so many options. A Raptor trade for Wizard doesn't seem terrible. Now I'm attacking because the amulet is going to kill my fledgling anyway. Yeah, an early amulet is pretty tough to beat. So we can play Felidar or Scythecats, get a landfall trigger. Probably just Felidar. Do I want to race or not? Not really. Although I might lose my Raptor anyway here. Getting close to slamming down the Baloth, which is going to be decent. Sadly, don't get to replay the Felidar here. Don't have any one mana plays, so we'll just pass. I guess never mind, we do have the 1-1 Death Touch. So I guess I could have kept up green and drawn main phase. Although I probably wasn't trading there anyway. I mean, this seems like a good turn for Baloth, if they're keeping up counter mana. And the race is on. Yeah, Relic Amulet is definitely very good if you can build around it. It helps if you have it in your opening hand, of course. It's not the best top deck. Scry to draw two. So Baloth can attack. Think playing Stomper is going to be better for me than playing Faladar. And then I can reclaim without Kicker, or I can just do nothing here. I don't think I pick up any lands. And then I'm just gonna pass, I think. Then I get to play Feldar, play my land, play this kicked afterwards. Yeah, maybe I should have picked up the Plateau actually. Probably would have been fine. This was the Predation. So this can be activated in response to me playing Faladar. And then pick up the Plateau now. They do have to remove all the counters from it. Probably better off just playing the flyer then. Alright, we're getting closer to 5 creatures to maybe take out a Colossus. Also gives me the flexibility of playing it as a land. Yeah, close call here. Could just play it as a land as well. Because this can take out my visionary, so I only have three creatures for the takedown. Didn't think an all-out attack is all that beneficial, because I get to eat a Felidar. But I'm probably into just playing this tapped now. Because then next turn if we draw lands, the first Felidar can attack. Uh-oh, kicked Royal Mage. That could be bad for me. Gets back a removal spell. Or an Insight. I need a good top deck. Not quite. So I don't have any great attack. They can still use amulets. If I attack, then they would just trade for my Baeloth, which is not what I want. And the Felidars will eventually outgrow the Colossus. We're at 13 cards versus 8 cards in library, so it could come to decking. Although Roiling Regrowth is kind of a nice one to have here. If I play it now, I can grow this twice, hit for 3 in the air, this gets 2 counters. Although they would still die to the Relic Amulet next turn. Probably just play Felidar and pass. Yeah, we probably lost like 4 creatures to the amulet so far. 4-4 flyer. Yeah, looks like a powerful blue-black control deck. So I could trade my fledgling for the Falconer. Don't know if that's really something I'm into. Assuming I have 2 lands left, which I think I do. I think if I can get 1 more land naturally and then regrowth, it's going to be better. I'll just pass for now. Into the Royal Mage. It's very thematic. Yeah, that's a powerful combo as well. So 6 cards left, bottom. I remember them bottoming 2 cards earlier as well, so they don't have many relevant cards left. So it could definitely come to decking here. Although Into the Royal plus Royal Mage can kind of keep looping forever. Although now we can maybe kill it in response. So do I have any good attacks? Not really, everything kind of just trades. second Relic Amulet. Okay. So the four bottom cards were all scryed to the bottom, I believe. Gotta sacrifice something. So currently I would die to the flyer before they end up decking. What's my best bet? Just the fledgling flying over, I guess. Drawing two lands in a row would do it. I think Baloth has to go. Ooh. I can even kick this. Alright, let's see what they have. Wow, what a game. That was super close. We needed that lucky top deck. Bit of a slow hand, but I'll keep. Could wait until we can kick it, although our deck does have a lot of 4 mana stuff. Play the plains, because if I draw Fledgling, I want to play Fledgling and enable Landfall afterwards. I'll kill the raptor here. Rabbit Bites. Doesn't seem needed here. I think I'm okay picking up two lands again since we have so many landfall creatures and not much we're ramping into. I think one Smite Monstrous is probably main deckable, but it's definitely not the best removal spell out there. They picked up Stampede again. Now we get to kill Stomper and attack with the Scythe Cat. Raptor can pick up a land, although it's not super useful. How would they block if I attacked? Would they trade the flyer? Would they triple block? Because if I can get rid of the flyer, then playing the raptor is pretty good, because it's a two-turn clock. I think I do attack with the Stomper here. Alright, that's good. They're giving us the choice. So Flyer needs to die, and then we can kill the Brute. I want to have 7 lands in case we top deck, or 7 drops. So this is 4 extra damage, plus 5 is 9, so I can attack. Let's see if they top deck their way out of it. Alright, sweet. Another close one here. Fine hand. If the fledgling survives, there is an argument for playing the regrowth now, so it's out of the 3 damage range from the common removal spell. Or we could wait to play Felidar first and then play the regrowth to get more landfall triggers. Definitely a close call here. I think I'm okay casting the regrowth, because we still have Raptor to pick up an extra land, so that's one more landfall trigger. I get to fix my mana. Next turn we get to go Felidar plus land. Sadly, they had a different removal spell. So I can play Raptor, pick up a land. And then probably want to kill the Wizard. Relic Amulets into a Molten Blast, dealing 2 damage. So do need to keep Swamp untapped here. Alright, Reclaim could be useful, probably want to kick it next turn. And then I can still play Soul Shatter afterwards. Diviner. Can't tap my black mana here. And then if I Soul Shatter now, they get to draw a card. I probably just only attack with the Felidar. Could also send Visionary, because Visionary is going to die to the Amulet next turn. And if they trade Royal Mage for Visionary, then the Diviner might not draw them a card when it dies. And then do I want a Soul Shatter now? Could be worth it. There's not that many blue or red creatures that are going to be bigger than the Felidar. Umara Mystic. Alright, so that can take out Electromancer, force another chum block there. Opponents empty-handed. Now the Scythe Cats. Let's see here. This goes up to 9 toughness, so we can still attack after we play the lands. And we won't trade. Yeah, the Prowling Felidar has been very impressive so far. Alright, one top deck to find an answer for Felidar. Alright, and the Felidar gets the job done. Sweet. Turn 2 Fledgling, turn 3 Vanquish. Is a bit too good to pass up. We're facing a blue-black rogue deck, so we might get milled here. At least we drew our one of swamp already. Forest would have been a nice draw. Alright, there's another one. This was a Jwari Disruption, so you can also sometimes tell what your opponent might be holding based on which lands they play. So far all their lands have been spells as well. Once again, double Umara Wizard, Rebirth. Seafloor Stalker. We're just gonna play the Felidar here. One mana Thirst to take care of our Fledgling. We have four cards in graveyard now. Eight is kind of the magic number, at which point a lot of the opponent's synergies might be enabled, including the Sneak, which we can still kill with Vanquish here. It seems good. I'll keep the Reclaim the Wastes in hand for now. Bubble Snare with Kicker to tap down Felidar. Maybe deciding if they want to play a spell as a land or not. And yep, they decided to run out the Mimic. I guess I could have gained two more life here by playing the Rogue first. That was a slight sequencing mistake. Although our life total doesn't matter a whole lot at the moment. A Rabbit Bite, nice draw. So, can play this Kicked. Don't think I send a Blight Blade. They chomp, chomp, and still die. No creatures, but a turn to spare supplies, which is a fine curve filler here. And then hopefully find some creatures along the way. Blight Blade works well with our Rapid Bites. Yeah, we're gonna have to kill that flyer eventually, so might as well do it now. They had a small pause. For single black, I guess they could have that trick that saves a creature at the cost of 2 life. So maybe I'm better off using supplies instead of Rabbit Bite. Sure. Then we'll just use supplies, play Visionary, and then afterwards Rabbit Bites. How many more hits of the Gloomhunter can I take? One more, probably. And then for now, play Felidar. A lot of ways to enable landfall in hand, so we wouldn't mind drawing more landfall creatures. So I've got an interesting choice. They're probably using the spare supplies, and then if they activate it in response, I could kill the Gloomhunter. With Vanquish the Weak, maybe? So they did have the trick, but they decide to use it on Survivor. Okay, and then I assume they're gonna put the counter on the Gloomhunter, and then we can kill the Gloomhunter in response. Puts it on the Sentinel instead. I see, so now it can attack as well. Fair enough. Do I kill the Sentinel instead of the Gloomhunter now? Yeah, I guess so. Play Adept first in case we draw a landfall creature. Although I'm probably casting Rabbit Bites. This is a sorcery. Alright, just waiting for more landfall creatures, pretty much. Otherwise we can play this kicked, which is still pretty strong. Shambler is a great card, although not amazing as a late top deck. Alright, 3-4 Crocodile. Well, I guess I'm just playing a kicked Surge here. Yeah, let's get in with all. Could die to a pump spell on the way back. But if I leave one back, it's pretty bad if they just have removal. Don't have many lands left in my deck, so most of our draws are good. That was an interesting block. I mean, there's no real sweepers I need to play around here. I'll just pick up a land and replay it, I guess. Think they're dead on board. No, they're definitely dead on board. Nice hand. Probably get Swamp on turn 1, so we can play turn 3 Vanquish if needed. Uh-oh. Please don't mill my Swamp. Oh no, this one doesn't mill. It's the other one that mills. So this could be a party type of deck. Think I'm okay racing. Rogue Cleric. So, yeah, can't really foil their tactic, sadly. In response to the trigger, killed Outrider so they don't have a warrior in play. Colossus, nice. 5 mana, 7/5, although there's a nice top deck. So, yeah, we'll attack. Kicked Bubble Snare. Okay. We're at 11. Next turn we can play a Baloth. Ooh, they're splashing red. Want to leave enough mana so I can play a kicked Vastwood Surge next turn, so I think I only pick up one land. Opponent's not dead on board, but they have to double chump. Healer, that's fine. Alright, I think we got there. I guess I have to double chump to stay alive. Maybe should have played around the 8 mana, destroy all non-land permanents, and kept the extra Felidar in hand. That was probably reasonable too. Alright, so we got to 7 wins in the end. The 2 games we lost was due to not being able to find any green mana, and we died with 4 or 5 green cards in hand. Don't know if I'll cut those out of the YouTube video since they weren't super interesting games, but definitely had a very interesting game, the one against Numot especially. So yeah, overall, first impression of Zendikar, pretty fun sets. Landfall is well supported with a lot of effects that let you pick up lands again in the late game. The spells that you can play as lands are great, give you a ton of decisions. Felidar, probably the card that overperformed the most. Definitely expected this card to be good, but I think it's even better than I imagined. And of course, a Fledgling was pretty decent too. And the Vastwood Surge also won us a few games just by putting 2 counters on the entire team. So yeah, pretty happy with how the first draft went here. want to thank everyone for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day. I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.